Yo, what's up guys, it's Corn7 here, coming back at you in another video. And in today's video, we are going to be rebuilding one of the more interesting teams in the league. I guess I wouldn't say interesting, but it's the Philadelphia Eagles. You know, they traded for A.J. Brown in the first round of this past draft class. In this past draft in the first round. Shocked a lot of people, you know, weren't expecting A.J. Brown to be on the move from the Titans, you know, thinking he was going to be their franchise wide receiver. Then he gets traded to Philadelphia. And now we got the Devontae Smith and A.J. Brown duo. But, I mean, the Eagles did make the playoffs in last year, but they got killed against the Buccaneers in the wild card round. This team has potential. I mean, they have a lot of young guys, but they have a lot of older guys, like many teams do. This Jordan Mailata guy, he's only 24. He's 81 overall. He doesn't have star, but he's still good enough and young enough where I think I should be able to keep him throughout the remainder of the rebuild. Hopefully he'll get stars at least some point. But I don't think I need to really worry about left tackle right now. 81 overall, only going to get better. Not as fast if he had star, but he should be solid. We got a rookie, should be star, better development. You know, he should develop, should be here for the remainder of the rebuild. Kelce, he's 33. Depends how fast he regresses. Like, if he goes down to, like, an 86, 85 for next year, I'll keep him around. But if he goes down to, like, the lower 80s, and I'm like, okay, I may look to trade him next year. But he should be solid for this year. I may look to get him better right guard. I don't think this guy's going to go anywhere development-wise. He should be solid for at least this year. Maybe I'll look to get a young one with star development for a guard. And then Lane Johnson, same as Kelce. Depends on how fast he regresses. I mean, he's 2 years younger, but I mean, if he could stick around in the mid-80s, I'll keep him around. But who knows? Who knows? But he should be solid for this year. We got Jalen Hurts as our quarterback. Wish he has star development, but who knows? If he doesn't play well this year, I may look to get Bryce Young or a different quarterback. But who knows? Maybe Hurts can play well with us. He has good speed. Doesn't have a lot of hit. Doesn't have big throw power, but hopefully with the addition of A.J. Brown and have Devontae Smith, he could play well. Quez Watkins, speedster, 94 speed. I might put him in the slot. And we got Josh Pascal and Greg Ward. But yeah, the offense, it's probably not going to be the strong point, but it should be decent. The defense should play well. I gave N'Kobe Dean star dub. I think it was a little disrespectful for the 69 overall. It's nice, but it's not nice. I think he's deserved at least a 74. I mean, he was basically the quarterback of the defense at Georgia, and Georgia had a really good defense last year. I think the only reason why he fell so much was because he needed surgery that he wasn't willing to get, but I think eventually he will. But I think he's a tremendous linebacker. If he were to have that surgery, he would have gone in the first round, you know, middle of the second round at the latest. So, you know, I know he was a third round draft pick, but I think he's a way better player than 6'10 overall. So that's why I gave him a star. Hopefully he develops. This guy's still young. Wish he was a little faster and wish he had star dev at 25, but if he gets star dev, you know, going into next year, we'll keep it around. If not, we'll look to get another Mike linebacker. Kazir White, same deal. He's 85. You know, if these guys can get their star devs, we'll keep them around because they should develop a little bit. But maybe we'll look to get a couple more linebackers. And secondary, Anthony Harris is getting older. I may look to trade him for some young piece. Marcus Epps, I'll probably look to get a better one too. Darius Slay is going to be here for the long run. He's 30, I know, but he's a good veteran to have on the secondary. Maddox, young enough, should be able to be here for the remainder of the rebuild. And then after that, I mean, I know this guy's young, but these guys are low overall. So we're looking to get some secondary pieces, some linebackers. There's still some work to do. On the defensive line, Hassan Reddick's not going to stick around. Oh, yes, actually. He is 26. He's going to stick around for the rebuild. I was meaning the other guy. Brandon Graham. He's 33. I'm going to look to trade him this year while he still has value. We're going to start Josh Sweat. He's 24 with Sardev. So he's going to start at left end. Hargrave. He should stick around. I mean, defensive tackles last a little long. Because that's why I'm going to keep these guys. Including Fletcher Cox, even though he's older. But these guys should be solid for the rebuild. And if it looks like there's not, I can always just grab one defensive tackle. But it's always good to have these guys here. Oh, that's right. They have Jordan Davis. I got to get started after him. You know what? I might actually totally forgot about the draft of Jordan Davis. I really did. He was just hidden. Yeah, he's going to get star. But now that changes things. I am going to keep Fletcher Cox because he has X Factor. But I am going to trade with Hargrave. I may package Graham and Hargrave. Who knows? Actually, you know what? They might actually be the right move to trade. What's the penalty? Ooh, he does have a big penalty. He has a big one. What about Graham? What's his penalty? Ooh, boy. Well, I think it's worth it, though. It opens up space. I don't expect us to be that competitive this year, so let me get these two trades done. I'm not going to go pick up OBJ and Brad Bear. I'm only going to pick him up if we're trying to compete this year. And I think that it's just better to just develop the young guys. But let's just see what I can get for them. I don't expect much from Gramps. He's already 33. Wow, they have a lot of cap space. Holy moly. I know that's the preseason. And the Bears have a lot of cap space too. But who knows? Hopefully that remains true for the offseason. Let's see. Yellows. Is there any greens? I doubt there's going to be any green. I think it's just going to be a lot of yellow. Yeah. So, let's see what we can take from the Browns. Ronnie Harrison. I almost always get Ronnie Harrison. I would love to get Denzel Ward. Is that even possible? It might be if I give up a lot of draft picks, but I could get this guy out. I always get JOK, but JOK is a beast. I could put him on the outside, along with N'Kobe Dean. I would love to get Myles Garrett, but that's not happening. That's definitely not happening. Maybe I can try to get a guard. You know, maybe Wyatt Teller. He could take over a guard. You know, like, yeah, let's see how close this would be. I don't think it's going to be that close. But, oh my god, we're making this work. We're making this work. I think I'm going to have to resign Wyatt Teller at the end of this year, but I think it'll be worth it. Wow, we have 3 first-round draft picks. That's right. But I think a 5th should just do it. Okay, 4th, probably. That's as high as I'm going. I'll add a 5th if I have to, but yeah, I'm going to have to add a 5th. But I think this is a tremendous value. Oh, yeah, 2 5ths. Okay, I'll give up this one. It's a 5th round. I just don't really care. But, and that's a gun, that gun deal. That's a done deal. That's, wow. I think we just fleeced the Browns. was not expecting that. But now we need another left end. Oh, that's right. We have Josh Sweat. So I was able to do that. Now the offensive line is going to be pretty good. Hopefully Jalen Hurts can thrive on that. Get him star dev. Yep, JOK right outside. Edwards can stay there. It'll be all right. Well, maybe I should put the faster guy. He's 80. I think White, you know, he's the same overall, same age. But a little faster. So maybe we'll move him up. Yeah. Got the faster guy out there. All right, and the other guy I thought about trading. Where is he? Oh, Hargrave. That's right, it's going to move up Jordan Davis. All right, let's see what we can give a Hargrave. There should be up. There's a lot of green interest. Wow. Okay, so basically we're going to have our pick. Let's try to trade with a team we never really traded with, like the Giants. But who do the Giants have? They don't have a lot. They have Andrew Thomas, but I don't really need Xavier McKinney. Sounds good. Slow. Isaiah Lari. play middle linebacker because he has started better development. I projected the first number one overall pick. Could I get a first round pick for Hargrave? No, not even close. I don't think this is going to be close. Oh, it is! I did not expect that to go through. Because usually when you trade for a guy's hidden development, it usually takes much. But this is, I think, going to be our middle linebacker. Because he has star better development. And right now, now we just got a linebacker set. We're going to make him the middle, or Mike. I always call it middle. But it's really called Mike linebacker because they have the mic. But I'm still going to call it middle linebacker because they're in between the right and left outside. So, if you don't like it, then sue me. I don't care. He shouldn't be that low overall in there. Only a 70 from a 76. I mean, Dean did play Mike and George. Maybe I'll do that. Cause I mean that's six overall less. It's not even on my left. All right, I'll move to Kobe Dean at middle linebacker. That's where he was. I feel like, and he's still a 69, but that's fine. We'll just do that. Jordan Davis is there. Yep. All right, I think we're ready for year one. Defense is set except for the secondary, but we can get secondary in the offseason. I mean, Marshawn Lattimore's there. We're going to go after him. Yeah, I think that's it for year one. So let's start the simulating. I am going to put Quez Watkins in the slot just because he's the fastest. I want Sanders to develop. Alright. Like I said, I don't expect us to be that competitive this year. I am going to go with the Eagles playbooks, but I think we just set ourselves up for the future a little bit. But I hope to be able to compete for the playoffs for the next 3 years after this season. Oh, I got to send to the regular season because I got to set the draft class. But we got 3 first round draft picks. So we should be able to make some moves this offseason, whether it's by the draft or trading. And get some pretty good guys, you know, going forward. I'm excited to see if we can build a dynasty here. So. But like I said, I don't expect much in this year. But hopefully the players play well. And hopefully Jalen Hurts plays well too. Josh, what develops? Only 24, yeah. All right, let's get to year one. As long as we don't finish dead last in the division, I'll be happy for this year. Like I said, oop, I didn't mean to go just 1 week. Well, we won week one. Well, look at that. We're ahead in the division. I didn't mean to go year one. I went to advance. I kind of rushed that. Wow, we have 48. Now probably 49 overall quarterback. That is amazing. No. Alright. Like I said, I don't expect playoffs. But as long as I don't finish dead last, I'll be happy. Whoa, FanDuel just gave me $100, I think, in free bets. Is that true? Oh, and also, if you guys are into sports betting and you guys don't have a FanDuel account, hit me up and I can give you a link. And your first, and as long as you bet at least $10 on sports, you get a $50 free bet. Both of us will in sports. And then if you do the same thing with the link and bet $10 casino, we'll both get $50 there as well. So we get $100 total, but $50 for sports, $50 for the casino. We both will get it if you use my link, so just hit me up if you would like to use that. I think think FanDuel is the best sports book out there, in my opinion. There's some good books out there, but in my opinion, I think FanDuel is the best. Let's see. Did they really just give me $100? They did. They did just give me $100 in free bets. Awesome. I may use that. Let's go, FanDuel. And if you guys don't know, last rebuild, I went out offline league because I was tired of losing EA servers. Doing the same thing here. That's why the simulator takes a little longer for some reason offline. I don't know, but we're almost done. Let's see what happens in year one. We made the playoffs at 8-9. Could have gone 9-8, but we lost against the division winner, Cowboys, who didn't win the division by much. We could have won the division if we beat the freaking Cowboys. Yeah. Ah, that hurts. But we made the playoffs somehow. Our defense is up to an 80. It was like at a 76, if I remember correctly, when we started the year. So we improved dramatically on defense. But we made the playoffs, so whether we won the division or not, this is a lot better than what I expected. If we can make a deep run, Cinderella story. Let's see how everybody did. Jalen Hurts was a solid year. 4,200 yards, almost 4,300 yards, 32 touchdowns, 10 interceptions. I call that solid. I think that is a solid quarterback. So let's say we don't really need a quarterback as of right now. Rushing, Miles Sanders had a decent year, over 1,000 yards rushing. Could have got a little more touchdowns. Looks like Gainwell, the rookie, got a little bit more than him. And Hurts actually had 3 touchdowns. Receiving, Devontae Smith had a great year, over 1,000 yards receiving, 9 touchdowns, 3 yards more for AJ Brown, almost 1,000 yards for Quez Watkins, 7 touchdowns. So it looks like Hurts was distributing the ball pretty well. I'd like to see that. Let's see the defense. Nakobe Dean. Fletcher Cox had 19 tackles for a loss, 17 for Josh Sweat, 7 for Derek Barnett, 6 for Josiah Scott, and so on and so forth. 6 for the rookie, Jordan Davis. Let's see for sacks. 9 for Josh Sweat, 5.5 for Cox and Davis. Love to see that. Not a lot, but it's still solid. 3.5 for Barnett, 1.5 for Edwards. We got a sack for a cornerback and safety. So, pretty good here. Interceptions, we got 3 for Harris, 3 for Slay, 2 for Maddox, and 1 for Josiah Scott, who's still young enough if he gets started if he could develop, but he's such a low overall. Alright, let's look at the team before we start the playoffs and see how everybody developed and see what their overalls are. Jalen Hurts is up to a 75 from a 71 at the beginning of the year. Brown's up to a 91, 87 for Devontae Smith. Quez Watkins up to a 76. Everybody is a little bit better. Still the same overall for these two guys, that's good. Defense, 70 for Nakobe Dean. Only went up one overall through the entire season. I don't know how that's possible. I also don't know how it's possible this guy's still normal. But we all know he still has star better development. Yeah, Jordan Davis went up. Josh Sweat went up. Everybody pretty much went up. Except for Epps and Harris. But we made playoffs. Not I wasn't expecting to. We had a losing record. We still made the playoffs. So let's see if we can make a deep run. Can we beat the... who's better than us? Well, it's the same overall, but we have a better offense, but they have a better defense. We beat on the road against the Saints. No, we lost 34-17. It's kind of like what it was against the Buccaneers. It's a little worse. But we do have a lot of money, and we have 3 draft picks, so I expect us to make a lot of moves during the offseason. And this is, you know, like I said, I wasn't expecting to make the playoffs anyway, so I call this a successful year. We're 1 game away from winning the division, and we just lost Week 18. So it is what it is. So let's go to the offseason. This actually makes me excited going forward for the next 3 years. does that expire? I don't know. Cardinals beat the Chiefs in the Super Bowl. Cardinals won a Super Bowl with Kyler Murray. And wow, we have a lot of money. But good for the Cardinals. That's a new one. Alright, I have a feeling we're going to have a lot of people who need to resign. I know Wyatt Teller's probably going to be one of them. Okay, who's in here? Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Jason Kelsey's down to an 82. I may let him walk and try to get a better center. Yeah, we got a lot of people we got to bring back. Alright. Start with Wyatt Teller. I'll give you the bag. We have enough money for you for the remainder of the rebuild. Okay, good. I got him back. Fletcher Cox. He's still an 86 with X Factor. I'll keep him around for one more year. Yeah, 1 year sounds good. He's going to test out free agency. Of course he is. I'm going to try to bring him back on a cheap deal in free agency. Kelsey. God. Went down 5 overall. What is he asking for? I mean, I guess a 1 year. So at least I don't have to worry about center this year. Maybe in the next 2 years. Because I know after this free agency, there's a lot of offensive linemen that we can move around. So maybe 1 year should be fine. He should be solid. Oh, he's going to... Of course you are. Of course you are. Dallas Goedert's going to return. That's just a no-brainer. I'll give him the bag. Okay. You're going to stay. I need you. You're a solid left tackle. Okay, that's probably a little too much, but we have the money for it. Maddox is going to stay. He's young enough. We need depth, though. Okay. Harris, I'm going to let walk. Josh Sweat, obviously, can resign. Okay. TJ Edwards, I'm going to let walk. Well, we need a punter. So I don't have to worry about you for the remainder of the rebuild. Okay. I think that's it. Yeah. So we got a lot of holes to fill still this offseason, but I think we can still do it. We're going to need probably a younger corner. How do I franchise tag? Who's more expensive? 16 versus 11. We're going to do Kelsey. I'm going to try to bring back Cox in offseason. But the main guy's going to be Marshawn Lattimore. So let's see what we can do. Now, did Jalen Hurts get star dev? Yes, that's perfect. So he's going to be our quarterback. Offensive line looks fine. Maybe look to get it. How young are you? 26. Yeah, I'm going to look to get a younger center to be under Kelsey for a year. Linebackers are fine. I'm going to need safeties. A couple of safeties. Hopefully I can get Fletcher Cox. Marshawn Lattimore. Yeah. We got a little work to do. So, we got $34 million spent. Or just under. Chris Godwin's in here. Really? No, he's just going to offer too much. We have Brown and Devontae Smith, and he's actually going to be the older out of all three. So, as much as I like Chris Godwin, I'd rather go after Marshawn Lattimore, who's a little cheaper. So I'm still going to have to offer him the bag, just because you have to do that in this game. Alright, I'm going to have to offer him just a tad bit more, just so he is more inclined to accept it. Now we got $15 million. Try to get Cox. What, 2 years, actually. I thought I can get 2 years out of him. Hopefully he accepts that. And actually, that's all we can do. See if we can get those guys. And then I'll probably use one of my first round picks for safeties, just because I don't need all. I don't need three of them. I mainly only need one. If I can get an established player for the pick, then try to get a rookie, I'm gonna do it. Damn, we didn't get either. Okay, I think I'm gonna have to use two guys, two first round picks. Let's go see who I can fleece. That's Madden for you. That is total Madden for you. Alright, I do want AJ Terrell from the Falcons. So, I do want AJ Terrell. Superstar development. Yeah, he's coming to the team. But they really don't have anybody else. Ooh, the wait. Star center. That's what I need as a center. He can be under Kelsey for this year and take over. Yeah, that's what we can do. God, I wish you had star better development. But you don't. Oh, okay, so it looks like I'm going to have to go get a safety from another team, but I could get this guy. He's young enough, playing up to 180, with 80s. Slow, though. Well, I guess it's better than anybody we have. More of us. Oh, okay. This is, yeah. But I really want AJ Terrell. I really do. So I think this is gonna be worth it. 12. Okay, I'm gonna try to get it for as least as possible. Okay, we're gonna make this work. Give you a third. Let's see, is that just do it? Okay, I'm gonna have to give up a sixth. Bro, just it's gonna be that close. Just accept the damn thing. Can't find a fifth. It was that close to the. Thank you. All right, so that's gonna work out. Now I need some safeties. Preferably young safeties like Xavier McKinney. Okay, yeah, he is slower, but he's a superstar development and young. So Xavier McKinney. Oh, Julian, I wish you had star dev. Ugh. Okay, what's your zone? Not bad, and you're fast. What about Holmes? You have star dev. What's your man? Damn. I really want Xavier McKinney with superstar development. I'm gonna have to pass. Unfortunately, because I need two. Tracy Walker and Ellie for the Lions. Savage would not be a bad idea. Amos is older. But Savage, though, with superstar development, fast with good zone, he's going to be the guy. You know what? I think that Eric Stokes, he's so fast, but he doesn't have good. I think I can put Zaire Alexander out there. Oh, Savage is out there. I know this is his last year of his contract, though, so I'm going to have to re-sign him, which I hopefully should have the money for. Oh, shit. That is going to be Jeremy Shin, I wouldn't mind. I know. know what? These two guys are young enough and good enough, I think. Well, we can rock and roll with these guys. Your zone coverage sucks, though. Holy shit. Oh. Am I trying to get too much? Is that the thing? Okay, you should be good. That's just strong safety. Jonathan Abram. You know, I'll do it. I'll do it. Yeah, you guys are young enough, and Abram's better than anything we got. I do need another tackle. I'll go with Jordan Davis. It might be Nichols. Like I said, it was a safety. He was. He has actually a better development. How old is he? 26. So he's already 26? God, it feels like last year he was a rookie. About the same as... And you're 2 years younger. Maybe this would be us. Yeah, maybe instead of Abram, we'll go after Mullen, because he's younger, and, you know, he can transfer to safety. I really want Max Crosby. Is there any way I can get Max Crosby for a 19? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Screw Madden, I forgot about that. Ugh, oh, that's unfortunate. How long has this video been so far? That's only half hour. Okay. So I was gonna go after Morag, Mullen. Really want Max Crosby. Is there any way I can get Max Crosby for a is this any close? We're making this work. I don't care what it's gonna take. We're gonna make this work. I'm gonna have to give up a third or 2 seconds. I think this is well worth it. Yes, this is well worth it for the future. I'm sorry. We still need a defensive tackle, but I think I could just draft one with my pick I have at 12. Yeah. I mean, he says Jordan Davis should take over. I mean, we only need a guy that's... Now let's take a look at the team. Got our Jason Kelce replacement. Johnson didn't go down that much. That's good. You know what? We're going to make us on Reddit. Oh, you're not even... You are not even that heavy. I'm going to make you the right end, though, Max. How many years did you have left in your contract? Only 1 year. Okay, I'll worry about that when the time comes. Went to Eastern Michigan? No. Alright, we'll trade away Hassan Reddick for a defensive tackle. How about that? Because we don't need him anymore. And he's only 235, so... I mean, if he was around 300 pounds, I'll put him a tackle, but he's not big enough. But he should... Yeah, he's going to get some... You're not heavy enough or strong enough. DJ Reader doesn't sound too bad. I know he's 28, but tackles last a long time, and why not? Give me one good reason why I should not do this. I'll look to see if I can find a younger one, but DJ Reader should be easier to get. But Ed Oliver, that's the guy. That is the guy. Yes, Ed Oliver. His strength's not that bad, but he has great speed for a defensive tackle. But he's always been playing defensive tackle. Von Miller. Golly. This guy's more of a true. But man, if he can beat his guy, no one's stopping him up the middle. With that 83 speed, he has 80 power moves, 83 for the size moves. Yeah, this is gonna be our defensive tackle. Him and Jordan Davis. If it's gonna be that close, why not just accept it? Why not just accept the damn thing? Offer like a next year's 7th, and this is gonna go through. Like, that was just not even worth it. But yeah, him and Jordan Davis. Okay, the defense is set. We are gonna make Mullen the strong safety. He's a 78 as a cornerback. What I wonder is that strong safety. Hopefully, it doesn't go down too much. It's actually one overall better. I mean, you know, we got Terrell, Slay, Maddox. And with my first round pick, I may draft a cornerback to, like, Ringo or something like that. Yeah. All right. If he's still there, hopefully. So that's it. Let's go to the draft and see what we can do. This team should be a competitive team next year. I'd be disappointed if it's not. Especially after making the playoffs last year, and I think I made this team a lot better over this offseason. Alright. We have left, I think, the 12th. Yeah. And what is Ringo supposed to go? Okay. God, I have TJ Stroud going to day 3. What? Jalen Carter went first. Alright. I'm gonna have to. Hopefully Ringo doesn't go. Bryce Young goes to New England. Will Anderson goes to the Giants. Lions select. Defensive tackle. I don't know how far I want to go. I'll give it one more pick. Do I risk it? Alright. Where is he now? 3 picks away. Yeah, I'm going to have to trade up. Three spots to get Ringo. I don't want to risk him going off the board. Yeah. Hopefully that's like too much. I mean, I'm not saying it's gonna go straight up, but yeah, we're not gonna have any draft picks this year except for Ringo. Which is fine. I used my picks smartly, hopefully, in my opinion. Is it the Dolphins? I think it's the Dolphins. Right? No. And who the hell is the ninth? Totally forgot about that. Totally forgot it. I swear it was. Oh, it was the Bucks. I knew it was a Florida team. I just want to see how close it is. Wow, pretty damn close. And even next year, I'm not going to have a lot of picks either. Alright. Well, welcome to the team, Ringo, and after that, we're ready for year two. Hidden development, 94 speed, 94 acceleration. Yeah, we're going to have a really good secondary. All right, I'll let CPU handle the rest. I know Ringo's going to be good. I think he's going to be close to 80 overall. If I remember correctly from before... Well, I went that way, didn't I? I guess we'll go with this guy for depth. He's still round 1 and 2. He may suck. Who cares? He's fast. 75 speed, that's pretty fast for a lineman. But yeah, I really don't care. Alright, now. So we have pretty much 2 picks. I know that Ringo is going to be close to 80. If I remember the past, he was in the 80 with Stardev. So let's see where he's at the beginning. Yeah, 78, 61. I knew he was going to be bad. But yeah. Yeah, he may actually, he's actually going to surpass Maddox. Maddox is going to be the fourth guy, but now this team should be ready to compete. Don't have a lot of draft picks, but that's okay. I traded for guys that can help us win now, because we are now officially in win now mode. I'm surprised our defense is only an 80. I expect it to be a little higher. I think it's because of our linebacker, how low overall they are, and same with the safeties. But I think as the season progresses, they'll get more in the mid-80s. That's what I kind of expected, but... Here's the team for year one, or year two, I mean. Yeah, I like it. I like it a lot. Kelsey's going to go away. This guy's going to take over. This guy should hopefully keep solid. Watkins is still going to be our slot guy. But yeah, the defense I'm most proud of right now. This should work out. You know, Kobe Dean shouldn't. He should be up there. Mike, a linebacker. Ballin should be good. Here's Ringo's stats. 94 speed, 77 man. Really good rookie. But yeah, this team's ready to hopefully compete. Alright, let's just go with him to the playoffs and we'll see what happens. We're going to keep the same playbooks. Because they seemed to work last year. But if they don't work this year, we will change playbooks. But hopefully everybody develops and all that throughout the year. And hopefully we'll see another playoff appearance. And at least a better record than 8-9. But you know, it's always Madden simulation. So pretty much anything can happen. Wow. Timberwolves are trading Malik Beasley, Patrick Beverley, Walker Kisler, Jared Vanderbilt, and multiple first-round picks to the Jazz for Rudy Gobert. But as far as I know, Karl Anthony Towns literally just signed a 4-year max. And then I got Rudy Gobert and Karl Anthony Towns. They're both true centers. I mean, yeah, Cat can shoot, and I guess maybe they may run him at the power forward, but they're both true centers. Neither of them are... I don't know how that's going to work. Either that, or... maybe it's a trade and I don't know what they're... I feel like that's a bad move by the Timberwolves. They just signed Karl Anthony Towns to a max. And then they just traded for Rudy Gobert. I don't know what they're going to do. I mean... but that, I guess, is not my problem. But we're almost done with the season. Let's see what happens. See if we actually made the playoffs. But that is interesting. Signing your center to a max, then training for another all-star center. Neither of them really can play the four. And we win the division at 11-6. That's what I expected. We face against the 9-8 Giants at home in the wild card. One last hurrah. Who's this for? Might be for Kelsey. It is for Jason Kelsey. So that we're going to get a little morale boost. Let's win it for Jason Kelsey. All right, let's see how everybody did before we start the playoffs. Let's see how everybody developed. And we'll look at the stats. Devontae Smith's up to a 91, 93 for Antonio Brown. Watkins is at a 78, 77 for Jalen Hurts. 84 for Jason Kelsey, 85 for this guy, 80 for this guy. Yeah, we're gonna be setting the offensive line for sure. Defense, Dean's up to a 74, solid. The other two guys are up to an 80. These guys are all really, really good. Ringo's up to an 80. Maddox is up to an 81. 80, 82. Yeah, a lot of 80s. A lot of freaking 80s. Oh, shoot. Oh, wait, yeah, he's still there. But I wanted Miles Sanders as third down running back. And I wanted Ringo at slot. Damn, I should have looked at that. But other than that, actually, we're pretty good. So, let's see if we can make a run now. This is where I expect us to make a little run. Let's look and see how everybody did. See how Jalen Hurts did. Hurts, not as many passing yards. A little more interceptions. Got to cut those down. But still, I guess it's a solid year. Brought us to a playoffs, 11-6. But got to cut those interceptions down and pass more. Rushing, Miles Sanders had a really good year at over 1,000 rushing yards with 15 touchdowns. Hurts had two of them. Receiving, no one over 1,000 yards, but we got four receivers in the 800 range, including one of them tight end. Touchdowns were pretty much well spread. I mean, not a lot of passing yards, but we got a lot of touchdowns, so looks like everybody had a... What's the term? Everybody had a evenly distributed, I guess I should say. But I guess we could change the playbook to, like, he has good speed, so something with, like, read options. Like, maybe Arizona, maybe we'll do that. They just won the Super Bowl last year, so we'll change to Arizona next year. But we'll keep the same playbooks for this year and see if we can make a deep run. This time we're at home in the wild card, faced against the division rivals, the Giants. Let's see what happens. Please don't be first round exits. We are not. We won 23-19. And now we go to face the Panthers. We are better than them in every way except for defense. We are tied with them, but we're better in the offense. And the overall, we are better. But that doesn't mean much. Still get that morale boost. I think we'll get another one throughout here. Yeah, it's up to you, Jalen Hurts. Got the morale boost. We gotta continue this. Come on, let's make it to the NFC Championship game on the road against the Panthers. And we lost. That's unfortunate. That's very unfortunate. This is not gonna be a happy ending. He may actually stick around. Who knows? After that loss. But that's unfortunate. But we did improve. We did improve, for sure. We won the division. Made it to the divisional. So the next 2 years, I expect Super Bowl after what I do. So Let's go to the offseason. We'll have a little bit of money, looks like. Could probably got to resign some players. Probably Max Crosby, and that's going to be a lot of money. But, yeah, hopefully we have some money to sign some guys and just keep improving. The Jaguars beat the Saints in the Super Bowl. Okay, that's... All right, let's resign some guys. We got a lot of money still, too, so... Alright. Yeah, we got a lot of people. Holy crap. Wow. Yeah, I'm sorry, Kelsey, but you're not sticking around. But you are. You're not. I know we want depth, but I'm trying to save money here. So, these guys are gone. The only guys I care about is AJ Brown. Please accept this. You're getting franchise tagged. I'm sorry. Miles Sanders, please don't be expensive. Okay, you're back. Ed Oliver, please don't be expensive. Okay, you're not good. But I am going to give you a little more than probably should. Just because I wanted you to stay. Please don't be too expensive. Okay. Alright, and I'm franchise tagging AJ Brown. I'm sorry. It's a lot, but... I had to do it. But we should still have some money for free agency, though. Yeah, about $40 million. So that's pretty good. Yeah, $41 million. Hopefully this free agency isn't as dry as was the last one. Lamar Jackson's here. I think we're going to run with Jalen Hurts, though, even though Lamar's here. I don't want to use my money on that. We got Max Crosby and Josh Sweat. So Montez, are they related? Should we bring the Sweat brothers together? 91 speed, gah. But we have Darnell Savage here. I know we got Warren, but Savage is here. This, we really don't need much. Well, Slay is getting older, so maybe. Maybe, like, Murty Bunting, probably, is the guy we should go after. He's not getting that much interest, so. Yeah, I get him, and Slay's there, but I may trade Slay. Yeah, I got to offer a contract to Savage. I have to. I'm sorry, that's probably a lot, but I want him to be on this team. Wow! Even that and the Vikings still have it. I'm gonna upgrade this. We do have the money for it. I swear to God, if that doesn't go past the Vikings. Way. And you know what? We're bringing back the Sweat Brothers. You cannot have too many. We're gonna do it. We're gonna do it. Hopefully he accepts. But that's it. We really don't need much more people. Well, except for a kicker, it looks like. Guess we'll go after Will Lutz. He has a good leg, doesn't he? 97? Yeah. For the remainder of the rebuild? Yeah. Whoa, what? $3 million? Are you telling me I don't have enough for a kicker? Hopefully he accepts that. Okay, well, that's it. Superstar development for JOK. Let's see what happens for agency. I don't expect everybody, but let's see what happens. Come on. We didn't get swept, but we got Savage Martin Bumpton. I really wasn't too... Like, I'm not upset that Sweat didn't sign with us, because we already have a Sweat, and he is young and, you know, already in the 80s, and I would just see if we could bring the Sweat brothers together. I don't even know if they actually are brothers. Are they actually brothers? Thank you. They are brothers. Okay. So I guess it would have been cool that we could have brought the brothers together, but I guess Sweat didn't want the contract I offered him. But we got Savage and Murty Bunting, so our secondary should look a lot better now. We still have the other guy for depth, because it's always good to have depth, even though there's no injuries. But let's take a look at the roster. Yeah. God, Quez Watkins up to an 80, but he doesn't have star. I guess he just doesn't have that one season that didn't give him a star, but he's still really good with that speed. Really good, really good, whatchamacallit? Season. Yeah. Can't speak right now. But Ed Oliver's up to a superstar. JOK is up to a superstar. I may start Morag over Mullen. Who has the better zone? You have 86, or 85, I mean. And you have 81. Yeah, I want the better zone. Terrell's up to an X Factor. That's awesome. Yeah, we have a pretty good core. Ringo's... Actually, you know what? We're going to trade Dwight Slay. I don't know for what. Maybe a wide receiver. Why? What do we need? We don't really need anybody. We have the team right here. Yeah. Okay. But yeah, I am going to change more to strong safety. Just because he has a better zone. But after that, we're going to go into year three. I'm not even going to worry about the draft. I'm going to let the CPU do the draft. This team should be dangerous. This team really should be dangerous. But yeah, I am going to switch it to the Arizona Cardinals playbook. But I'm going to keep the same defensive playbook. Because the defense really wasn't that bad. It's the offense that was not that good. So let's see how the Arizona playbook does. I mean, they beat the Chiefs in the Super Bowl, so it has to be pretty good. Wrong button. Two more years. So if we can get a Super Bowl out of it. I've never run an Arizona playbook, so see how that actually works out. Yeah, like, so I'm not going to worry about the draft. I'm kind of curious to see what we get. So instead of just going over the next season, let's just go to the draft and have them simulate it. I'm kind of curious to see what we get. I know we don't have a lot of draft picks this year, but I still think we have a first-round pick. So it'll be kind of interesting. Got Will Lutz! Awesome! Took that terrible contract, but... Well, we needed a kicker, so that's good. Get the draft done. Let's see how the CPU drafted. Drafted a 75 overall tight end, a 70 overall right end. You have hidden development. Okay, two, and he's fast with a lot of good catching. And then this guy, he's never gonna play. But cool. Got Dallas Goedert and him. Guess it's good to have two tight ends. I guess. All right, let's get into year three. I expect us again to win the division, and even better than 11-6 record. Let's get to there. Now, am I smart for holding on to Jalen Hurts? Probably not. Hopefully it works out. The only reason why I kept him is because he got star dev. And with the star dev, he's still young enough where he can develop. If he didn't get star dev, I would have looked for probably Bryce Young. Or, you know, get a quarterback. Or maybe I even offered a contract to Lamar Jackson. But he would have been so expensive. But with how Jalen Hurts is so young, and that he got star dev during the first season, he should be in the mid-80s by the final year. Maybe after this year. Which is should be good enough. As long as he has a good team around him. He has a pretty good offense. He has two good wide receivers and a good slot guy in Quez Watkins. And really good defense to back him up. I think that Jalen Hurts should be solid for us. And he should win us a Super Bowl. Hopefully it works out. We got two seasons to do it. But that's the only reason why I kept Jalen Hurts. Because he got star dev. And I was like, okay, I don't have to worry about that. But if he didn't get star dev after the first season of this rebuild, I probably wouldn't have saved him. I probably would have either traded for a quarterback or drafted one, which is probably would have been Bryce Young. But since he got star dev, I worried about other positions of need and tried to build up a team around him. So hopefully he doesn't blow up in my face. But so far, we made the playoffs twice, won the division once. So as long as we get a Super Bowl out of it, I made the right decision. And hopefully this year we make a run for the Super Bowl, get past the divisional round. We went 8-9 the first year. We're a game away from winning the division over the Cowboys. We just lost against them. We still made the playoffs, but we're first round exits against the Saints. Then we won the division last year 11-6, and we're second round exits against the Panthers. So hopefully it's something like that around 11-6 or 12-5. Winning the division. We're about to find out. Let's see. We won a division at 13-4. We probably got a first round bye. We beat the Cowboys 41-3 in week 18. Yeah. Yeah, this team is awesome. This team is awesome. Let's see how everybody did. Under the new Arizona Cardinals playbook. Not a lot of touchdowns, but more passing yards for Jalen Hurts. Rushing, Miles Sanders had 22 touchdowns and almost 1,000 rushing yards. Yeah, see, I knew that read option was going to be more of a key for Jalen Hurts because we got to use his speed. I mean, he may not throw a lot of touchdowns, but get 8 touchdown rushing touchdowns and nearly 700 rushing yards, that's and still have Sanders get 22 touchdowns, that's insane. And almost 1,000 yards rushing. Yeah, I think this is the playbook for us. Receiving 3 receivers over 1,000 yards. If Quez doesn't get star dev after this, I don't know what's going to give him star. But, yeah. Awesome. Defense. JOK. Ed Oliver with 23 tackles for a loss. Max Crosby with 18. 14 for Jordan Davis. 11 for Sweat. 5 for Mullen. 5 for, yeah. We're just going to go down the line. All right. QB sacks. 15.5 for Max Crosby, 7.5 for Ed Oliver, 6.5 for Josh Sweat, 5 for Jordan Davis, 2 for JOK, and 1 for Tyron Jackson. Interceptions. 6 for Trayvon Mullen, 5 for JOK, 4 for Darius Slay, 1 for Maddox, 1 for Trayvon, 1 for AJ Terrell, 1 for Savage. A lot of interceptions. 6 to the backup safety. That's funny. And then 5 for a linebacker. Wow. Let's go, JOK. Yeah, this team is special. This team is special. All right, now let's try to make a deep run now. We had a first-round bye. Let's see what we can do. I'm going to take a look at the team before we go. Okay, JOK. Oh, that's why he's specializing his pass coverage. Oh, let's might as well. Let's make him a pass coverage guy. I mean, plus 1 speed, man coverage, wow. He's going to get X-Factor, I think, at the end of this year. 90 speed. Wow. And Devontae Smith, probably make it a deep threat. Still at star, but you make a superstar at the end of this year. 99 catching. Awesome. And who would you do that? Well, let's see what we can do in the playoffs. At the divisional. We face in the divisional. San Francisco at 10-7. Let's take a look at the roster and see if anybody got any dev upgrades. 82 for Jalen Hurts. Okay. Quez is still at a... Okay, he might get it for Super Bowl week. Defense, anybody? Not really. Okay, why is Dean keep going down? Okay, I think it's because maybe he's not a middle linebacker. I gotta change his position. But he's developed actually quite nicely for these years. And actually, if I did, you know, more than just 4 years, he would develop into a pretty good Mike linebacker, in my opinion. If you give him a start at the beginning, though. But he's developing pretty good. Yeah, this team is developing quite nice. I think I built a pretty good team. In the third year, see if we can beat the, well, we actually have the same same overall offense. We have the better defense. We're home. I did all this talk and watch us lose against the 49ers. Hopefully it doesn't happen. We do. We win by 10. And now we face against the Vikings. We're going to hop in here in the conference championship. First, we're going to upgrade players. Jalen Reagor. God, he was such a bust. Such a bust. Got all that speed, and he's just such a bust. Can't catch a football to save his life. All right, well, let's hop in here and see if we can go to the Super Bowl. Like I said, I'm not going to play it. We're going to be facing the Chargers if we win this game. They beat the Chiefs in their championship round. Okay, let's see if we can beat. They score first. Looks like I have a turnover. We're in a 10-0 hole. We need to get going here. Down 17. Okay, we score right before halftime. Wow, we cut it to 7. We cut it to 4. Okay, looks like I'm going to have to hop in here. We're not losing against the Vikings. I'm sorry. I got to bring my team back. Let's go, Quez. Use your speed. And he's gone. He's gone. Let's go, Quez. You're not going to catch me. Let's go. Alrighty, my defense will step up here. Yeah, my defense will step up. And we got the turnover. Let's go, defense. Let's freaking go. I'm going to trust them to actually score. So I'm going to actually super sim play by play. Throwing away. Please don't settle for 3. And they had to settle for 3. And he missed the field goal? Did Will Lutz just miss the field goal? It's blocked. Wow. I should have been in there. I should have been in there. Defense got the stop. Wow. I thought we could actually score there. At least a field goal to tie it up, and couldn't even do that. Yeah. But we can still win this game. We can still win this game. Come on, Devontae. Oh my God, Jalen, what was that? What was that, Jalen? Come on, Quez. Let's go. Just get the first down. What the? Why did you stop? Oh, must have been that option. Either you can keep going or you can stop, and he decided to stop. Yeah, I wasn't expecting that. Damn. I'm gonna run this play one more time. Hopefully I can actually get Smith this time. Or maybe even Watkins. Oh no, we're gonna just hit Smith. We're gonna hit Devontae. He might be gone. Yeah, he's gone. Oh, he just caught him with the one. I'm not gonna reoption here. Oh my god, they're gonna give me the touchdown. I'm just gonna give it to Sanders. Too easy. Alright, defense. Need you guys to step up here. Need you guys to step up. They did. And it's just time to run out the clock. Is that... Okay, that's Brown. Just dump it off here. I think I'll trust them to run out the clock. I'll just keep running. Let's go! I brought us back. We're going to the Super Bowl to face the Chargers. What a big game by Jalen Hurts. It looked kind of bleak out there. We fell in a 17-0 hole, but we fought our way back. With a little help from me, but I didn't play anything on defense, so our defense stepped up when it needed to. I wish we got points after that turnover there, but, I mean, blocked field goals happen. We're going to get speed up. His power rush is still there, but hopefully we can get plus one speed. Nope, but we got finesse moves. It's pretty fast anyway. 99 power moves. I mean, we really don't need to upgrade that, but we're going to the Super Bowl in year three. This team is special. Let's win it. Let's win it against whatever their team is, the Chargers. Wow. Alright, I need you to be better at pass protecting. Good lord. Wow. Good run blocker, though. Alright, let's face the Chargers. Now we probably should see some dev upgrades. Let's see if anybody got some dev upgrades. None on the offense, which is kind of disappointing. Defense. X-Factor for Crosby and JOK. Ha! Let's go. Right, I know I should probably do one by one, but I'm just going to just have them CPU do everybody. Their best fit. Alright, let's get into the Super Bowl. Year 3. 11-6 Chargers versus the 13-4 Eagles. They're actually pretty... We're probably evenly matched. I mean, they have the better defense by 1. We have the better offense by 3. And we're better than them by 1. But I'm not going to take this lightly. Hopefully we can pull it off, though. Defense needs to play good. And offense needs to play good as well. Obviously, we just need to play well. Against the Chargers... Justin Herbert and Jalen Hurts. I think they're in the same draft class. Alright. So we don't fall into that hole again like we did last game. Doesn't look like... We missed the extra point. Okay, we're close. Okay, I'm going to have to hop in here. Just like last game, I have to come back here. I need to at least get a field goal here. What? I thought an easy completion to the tight end. Well, that might have just killed us. I thought we had an easy completion to get a tight end. Probably should have threw it to B. Second and a one. Oh, wow. Let's go. What a throw by Jalen Hurts. Wow, we got a lot of work to do in the fourth. And only 6 minutes to do it. Oh, shoot. I was going to say, what play did I just run? All right, Quez, I need you to use your speed here. He didn't catch it. They're going to review it. They have to. They're not going to review it? Well, it's too late now. Come on, guys. Oh, I had people. I had people. I was just afraid to throw it. I was just afraid to throw it. Oh, man. Oh, let's go. Let's go, Brown. No! I thought I had the tight end. That's it. Wow, we didn't win the Super Bowl. The Chargers were just too much. They were just too much. Well, we got one more year. God, that two interceptions I threw that I thought weren't going to be intercepted, and it turned out to be intercepted. Just bad reads. Just bad reads on my part. But still a successful year. We'll be back next year. I can guarantee you that. I don't know what I should do next. I mean, we have the team. It's just we need to just keep improving. Looks like we're going to have to re-sign a lot of guys, but we just got to keep improving. I mean, we'll continue to be better. I think we have the right playbook. Who needs to be? Okay, Max Crosby, Brown, Terrell, Slay, I'm going to let walk. Need to sign him. Jalen Hurts, Quez Watkins. Okie dokie. Well, let's start by doing Max Crosby. Bro. Oh, boy. Should do Hurts next. Bro, Hurts. Quez. You didn't get star after the season you had. That's disrespectful. Alright. Oh yeah, you. I'm not going to have any money for free agency. So basically, I'm going to have to choose Terrell or Crosby. Terrell, 21. 23. Okay, so Terrell's going to be cheaper. Am I going to have any money to re-sign Crosby? Or is it just a lost cause? I'm only going to have 10 mil. Oh, that hurts. Only $9 million. Lamar Jackson's still in here for Crosby, bro. He's literally the only player that I really want. I mean, it's just Max Crosby. I mean, I'm not going to go get Carl Lawson. He's too old. But whoever he signs, I'm going to have to trade for him. Wherever he signs, I'm going to trade for him. I don't care what it takes. But all right, let's see where he goes. Cardinals. Maybe I go after a different guy. But like who? Ooh. I'm gonna have to give up somebody for because of cap. Yeah, like I'm gonna get Myles Garrett. Why did he go to here? Yeah, they have a lot of right ends. They got this guy. Then they have this guy. Yeah, he's the less expensive. So we have enough cap for him. I'm going to have to offer two firsts. It's the final year, so it's time to go all out. Two firsts for Mr. Myles Garrett. Not Myles Garrett. Mr. Max Crosby. And a second. That's literally my best offer. That is literally my best offer. I can't offer him anything more. We cannot get. I'm gonna go find someone else. Because apparently, two first round picks aren't enough to get Myles Garrett. I keep calling him Myles Garrett. That's unfortunate. There has to be someone. Carl Loftus. He somehow got superstar development, and he's young. He may not be as fast. He's only 80. But with superstar, I might consider that if I can't get anybody else. Quiddy Pay might be a pretty good option. This really threw a wrench into things. This really did. I did not have a plan for if I couldn't resign. Okay, it's going to be Chase Young. I'm sorry. Yeah, it's going to be Chase Young. He's actually pretty cheap. Hopefully we can get him. He's a pretty good Max Crosby replacement. And he doesn't have X Factor, so he's two firsts. Hopefully should. Yeah, we're going to get Chase Young. All right. Thank you. All right. Chase Young is not a bad replacement for Myles Crosby. So instead of saying Myles Garrett, I mixed their names to Myles Crosby. Oh boy, it just gets one of those days. Alright, we got pretty much everybody else back, which is good. It's the final year. Yeah. Alright, Josh Sweat is going back to left end. But yeah, I think this team should continue to develop, and yeah. We should be around 13-4 again. That's that. I'm expecting that. That is hilarious. This guy did not get star dev, but he's up to an 86, so he's solid. Same thing with that guy who lost superstar development, but he's still up to an 87, so he's solid. Dean lost his star somehow. I'm gonna give it back to him, I'm sorry. I don't know what he did to lose it. Maybe because we lost? I don't know. But I need him to continue to develop. I want to get Watkins star dev, but it's alright. Actually, I want to put Ringo in the slot. He's a little faster. Yep. Well, wait a minute. We need to put Miles. We need to put Chase Young in this. I did not see Chase Young. We need to put him there. Probably in for Ojulari for rush left end. Yeah, we gotta put Chase Young there. We gotta have Chase Young in a specialist. What? Oh. Ha! Yeah, I want. Yeah, that guy to be there. I thought it was going to bring it right to it, but it didn't. But, okay. I'm an idiot. Alright. There we go. That looks a lot better. Now let's start year four. I'm not going to worry about the draft either. Final year. I don't even care what rookies we get. Final year, Super Bowl or bust. We got to the Super Bowl. We made a few mistakes. I'm the one who did them, but we shouldn't have put ourselves in that position. We needed to play better. I'm gonna keep the Cardinals playbook because it seemed to work out very well, and I'm gonna keep the Eagles playbook for defense. Maybe I'll run Baltimore. I like Baltimore's defense, but wait, how bad was our defense last year? Oh, it's already been not this year. I don't think I think it worked just fine. So, wow, Damian Harris is a superstar superstar development. That's pretty cool. All right, let's see. We went 13-4 last year. Let's see if we can do it this year. Let's say we make the playoffs. I'm still gonna call this a dynasty per se. Even though we didn't win a Super Bowl, we made it to one. We made the playoffs all 3 years, including the first year, which I didn't expect to happen. And then we got to a 13-4 record in 2 years. Depending on what happens this year, I may call this a dynasty. I don't know. I mean, I know winning championships is a requirement to call yourself a dynasty. But under the circumstances, in basically 3 years, and that, you know, two off seasons, I made this team a 13-4 team. I think that's a pretty damn good job. But hopefully we can cap it off with a Super Bowl. Then I can really call this a dynasty. But now if I had to do anything differently, I mean, I'm not calling this rebuild a failure. I think I built a phenomenal team, you know, and I just wish I could have kept Max Crosby, but, Chase Young is not a bad replacement. If I had to do anything differently, probably might have gone with Bryce Young instead of Jalen Hurts, but Jalen Hurts is now good enough to, I think, be a Super Bowl winning quarterback in this league. I don't know in real life. That just time will tell. But since, like, in the, I said this earlier in the video, since he got star development after the first season, I knew that he was going to be our franchise guy because I knew he would develop. I mean, he was in the low 80s at the Super Bowl. After this season, he should be in the mid to high 80s. Maybe even reach 90. Who knows? Depends on how good he has this season, which we're about to find out. And hopefully Madden Sim doesn't get us and we go like 5-12. So, which I don't expect. But let's see what happens. Madden Sim got us. After going 13-4 and barely not changing anything, we go to 8-9 again and miss the playoffs by one game again. Best season yet for Jalen Hurts. Rushing, still pretty good. Receiving, phenomenal. Defense, not as many turnovers. What happened? Should I have changed it to Baltimore's defense? No, it actually was our offense. It was the quarterback. Passing yards, actually. No, passing yards game was pretty good. The rushing game was not that good. And the points per game was not that good. Well, I'm not going to call this a dynasty. I thought I built a pretty good team. I guess I took a chance running on Jalen Hurts. But I mean, look at him now. After this season, he's up to an 81, I guess. I thought he was going to be in the mid to higher. But I mean, this offensive line is awesome. Maybe I could have got a better running back than Miles Sanders. I guess maybe he's more of a catching running back. You know what? We have time. Yeah, he's... could have gotten another established running back. I don't know what's wrong. I mean, I swear this team... in real life, I don't think this team misses the playoffs. I think Madden got us in this final year. But it is what it is. I think I rebuilt this team pretty well. You know, I think I did. They had a 4 years playoffs. Made it to the Super Bowl last year. Wish we would have won it. But I think I did a pretty damn good job. Let me know what you guys think. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace out.